for the, those of you that have ever worked with concrete before, there's a certain amount of water in conventional concrete that's really not needed for hydration. What happens is, as concrete's placed, all the material tends to settle a little bit in place, and it forces the excess water up through the capillary pores to the surface. It's called bleed water. Typically on concrete, you don't finish that bleed water into the concrete. You have to let it evaporate. If you finish it into the concrete too early, you trap that water into the concrete, and then when it freeze thaws in this area, the sidewalk or the someone's driveway or something will peel off in the very first winter, and you get, you know, the trouble phone calls. 99% of the time it's because they sealed the bleed water into the concrete. Conventional concrete, you have to let that bleed water come up and evaporate. With high performance concrete, particularly with silica fume, remember, we don't have these bleed water channels. We don't have these capillary pores. The silica fume is, those little BBs have filled in between all of those baseballs, so there is no capillary pores. There is no bleed water. And for finishers out on site, it's a little bit different because there's no bleed water. They don't have to wait to finish it. And because they've been doing the same thing forever and ever, you know, 30, 50 years, I've been finishing the concrete the same way. You know, I'm not going to finish it any way different. It's different. You're not making 1950 concrete. We're making, you know, 2000 concrete, high performance concrete that's going to last 2-3 times longer than it did before. One of its properties is there's no bleed water. Even in a fresh state, it's very low in permeability. You've closed off all those capillary pores. So the placement techniques get a little bit different. What they, what this little video here that we'll play is actually the Chicago Skyway looking west, or actually north right now. Gary, Indiana's behind us. The bridge decks there were just repaired in 03 with high-performance concrete. This is a video showing their placement techniques that are a little bit different than what most people think of with concrete with bleed water. In this case, they're finishing and placing and doing all of this and having it cured within 15 minutes after placement. We saw in that one video at Kinzua Dam where they were placing the concrete and spraying it with curing compound right behind it, that white pigmented curing compound on top. In this case, they're going to cure it, but they're going to cure it with wet mats, wet burlap, wet cotton mats they're going to actually lay on the concrete. The idea is to keep the water that's in the concrete so that it hydrates the cement. If in a condition like this where we have direct sunlight, wind blowing, low humidities, the same thing that we saw happen on the aggregates in the Sierras would happen to fresh concrete. The evaporation on the surface would be so great that the concrete would start to crack, would start to dry out like a lake bed before it had a chance to get hard. It's going to take a couple hours for it to set up for that chemical reaction to happen. So this is what they this is what the video looks like on a placement of a bridge. They've learned to control cracking on bridges by staggering the placement of the reinforcement over top of one another. You can see how they're staggered here. Engineers like to draw things in nice on a blueprint and what have you, but reality is those bars above one another cause a stress riser and can cause cracking. So they stagger the top and bottom mats. Here's the concrete being delivered to site. It'll be pumped onto the bridge deck. That's probably a 7.5-inch slump concrete being pumped onto site. Note what's on the bottom of this hose. You never let concrete free fall out of the hose. They have a little S here on the bottom, so the pump literally has to pump it out. If it free falls directly out of the hose and smacks against the deck, most cases you lose a lot of air entrainment. Those little air bubbles that you purposefully put in there for freeze thaw get collapsed, and then you don't have good concrete for freeze thaw. So that's why they put that little S underneath there. It makes you pump it out. You can see the guys are only finishing outside the rails. You can see the wet cotton mats are being placed on very close behind the bridge paver. I actually, on a job site, these rails, I actually like to put the rails out of the pavement area. If you only need hand finishers for what's outside the rails, we'll make nothing outside the rails. Put the rails outside the structure. Put the rails on top of this parapet here and on the other parapet so that there is nothing here for the hand finishers to finish. See all these guys working outside the rails? And they're going to do that all the way back because they have to pull these rails out and they're going to close the surface and hand finish it. Why? You've got extra labor there. The machine does a wonderful job inside the rails. Well, make it so that the rails are the whole thing. You can save a lot of labor in this case. They eventually did this, but you can see they had, you know, they've got three extra guys on both sides just to finish 1 foot of concrete. I mean, it's crazy. It's crazy.
S-shift,
hose?
Yeah, hose. Help in segregation, prevent segregation also, or just
for air? More so for air, to keep the air in the concrete. When they got too far ahead, they actually stopped their placement and let the guys on the wet burlap here catch up. Without bleed water on this concrete, you don't want it to surface dry, so they got it protected under underwater, and you could see them spraying the water on the surface. They try to keep the placement of the concrete very close here for the same reason. Everything is, they call it fast track construction. The concrete goes down, the bridge paver paves it, the curing is right behind it, and everybody goes home. The next thing that's going to happen is the paving guys are going to be smart enough. You see they've got a paver that has rollers and a pan drag and a wet burlap drag. The next thing they need to invent is the wet burlap being placed automatically behind the paver. So as the paver goes down the bridge, everything gets done completely. There's even less labor out there if you do it right. There's a lot of potential out there to use. As the one video said from New York, you know, this concrete actually gets placed easier because there's no bleed water. You can fast track the construction, and the technology is slowly catching up with new equipment all the time to take advantage of that technology.
How does the wet burlap play with the bleeding that you want to operate?
Well, with conventional concrete, you wouldn't finish this way. You couldn't put the wet burlap on right away. You'd have to let conventional concrete bleed and that bleed water to come up, otherwise you'd be trapping it into the concrete. But with this high-performance concrete with silica fume, and there is no bleed water, Chapter 8 in the manual goes into great detail for contractors how to place and finish silica fume concrete bridge decks and parking garages, which are the two biggest flatwork applications for it. And the whole thing is to fast-track it. Place it, finish it, texture it, cure it, go home. Don't wait the 3-5 hours. You can finish it a lot quicker. The hard part is getting the guys that have been doing this for 30 years to change. You know, that's where you guys are important, because you're the change. You only know one way to do it. You don't have 30 years of the wrong way of doing it. A typical bridge deck then, when the placement is really going efficiently, looks like this. You can see the placement machine up here in the green steel. They've drug an AstroTurf on a broom to give this texture, real rough texture. And the wet burlap, you can see the proximity. And you can also see there's no bleed water. There's no shininess on this concrete. You can't walk on this. This is still fresh. There's no bleed water, but it's done. There's nothing left. There's nothing better to do than put it under wet burlap and go home. Don't overwork it. The hand tools that you see, the finishing tools, and all those extra tools for laborers, they're the worst things for concrete. The concrete, very pragmatically, it's as good as it gets coming down the chute of that truck. There's nothing a contractor can do to make that concrete any better from a durability standpoint other than to do whatever it is he has to build it and do it with the least amount of effort possible. If you got finishing machines to finish it, fine. Put your rails out here, see the rail here, so that the bridge machine can finish all the way to where the parapet rebar are. You don't have any laborers on the side to do it. The machine's doing everything for you. Take advantage of all those things. This is a parking deck up in Milwaukee. You can see the proximity of where they're placing it. Well, they're actually moving the screed from here. You can see them walking it over to here. But literally, 10 feet behind the screed, they've closed the surface and texture it and spraying it with the curing compound. They're done. Don't have to come back and work it again. That's it. Thanks, guys. Hold on. Any questions?